day class and welcome again sa ating science class. Welcome in our virtual laboratory. Together with me is Dexter Laboratory. And today, we are now in quarter 3, week 3 of our lesson. Specifically, the topic we'll discuss today, the physical and the chemical changes. But in the lesson, at the following objectives, we will explain the physical changes in terms of the arrangement and motion of atoms and molecules. Second thing, we need to differentiate physical from chemical change. And lastly, we need to develop communication, critical thinking, creativity, collaboration, and character in this lesson. So are you ready? But before that, class, we will be on right class. Before we proceed to our lesson proper, let's have some review if you really understand our previous lessons. So let's get on. As we all know, when we take up, is a description of an object, like what you see in this picture. As you can see, as you describe the color of the tree, you can simply say that the tree is color green. The leaves of the tree is color green. And how about its size? The tree is tall. That is the property or simply the description of an object. And the last one, if struck by lightning, the tree could catch fire and it will burn. So these are the sum of the property of a tree. It is color green, it is tall, and also it can be burned. Yon, that is what the physical properties based on what we had discussed last time. Physical properties are determined by use of the, so how, paano nyo nakita yung color, paano nyo na-determine kung gaano kalaki, with the use of your very good 5 senses. So what those 5 senses? Sige, you can type your answers on the chat box. They are a description of an object. Okay, very good. What are those 5 senses? We have the sense of sight, sense of hearing, sense of taste, sense of touch, and sense of smelling. You can use your 5 senses for you to identify or to describe an object. Of course, in smelling, you will use your nose. In touching, you can use your hand, of course. In tasting, you can use your tongue or your lips. And in hearing, you can use your ears, of course. And last, for us to see an object, for us to describe, we can use our eyes. Alright, moving forward, these are the examples of physical properties. Okay? Color, smell, or taste, hardness and softness of an object, state of matter, we can identify if it's solid, liquid, or gas. Of course, the boiling and freezing. The melting point. These are the example of physical properties. But aside from that, meron pa, ito yung na-discuss natin last week. Ano po? It is the density. We are able to measure the density of an object. First, mass of an object. The physical properties also is the volume and the malleability. When you say malleability, this is the ability to be molded. Like a metal. The physical properties of a metal, it can be molded. It also the clay. Diba? We can mold it into different formation. And solubility, the ability to be dissolved. Okay, like for example, physical properties of a sugar, a salt. Now, one of these example is how the ability of to be dissolved. That's what we call solubility. Again, what are those? We have density, mass, malleability, solubility, and so on and so forth. Yung nauna nating na-flash. Now, pag sinabi naman po nating chemical properties, these are the properties of a chemical. Are determined as substances ability to blend with other substances. What do you mean the other blend? Anyone? React. It means that there is reaction happen. If we can consider, if it is, if we can consider this as a chemical properties. These are the examples of the chemical properties. First is the ability to react with air, producing rust, tarnish, or corrode, and rot. This is the ability to react with water and acids, the ability to catch fire, flammability. These are the chemical properties of an object. Also, let us proceed to our lesson. According to our President Duterte, change is coming. So, what do you mean by change? Another statement, we have change is happening all around us. As all of that time, ulit, the change is happening all around us, all of the time. Sabihin, may pagbabago, minsan, ngayon masaya ka, kanina pala, inaantok ka, and now, you are feeling alive, kanina gutom ka, na nakapag-breakfast ka o nakapag-birienda ka, okay ka na, nakapag-lunch ka. Kung ano man nakakain ka na, okay ka na ngayon. Kanina, you feel like tinatamad. Ngayon, sinisipag ka na, yes. And, ibig sabihin, nagbago na siya, nagkaroon ng changes. Sideboard be like, kasi nagbago na. Dati, mahal ka, ngayon hindi na. Pero bawal muna yung love-love na yan, mag-aral muna ha. So, change is happening all around us. And according to chemists, chemists learns a lot about the nature of matter by studying the change that matter can undergo. Changes that matter can undergo. It means that the matter can undergo in the different process. That's why there is a changes. Parang kanina, diba? Like for example, nag-undergo ka ng eating, that's why you feel better right now. Kanina gutom ka. You're undergoing the process of digesting the food, naging okay ka na. But in this time, chemists make a distinction between two different types of changes that they study. It's just simply studying an object or a situation for them to clarify or to check the different types of matter. A physical change or chemical change. So, two changes that we will study for today is the physical and chemical change. So, before that, let us unlock those terms that are very important in studying this lesson. It will help us really understand our lesson for today. Let us unlock first. All you need to do is to repeat letters to form the right term or right word on a given definition. Okay, number one, any material that possesses physical properties is called a... That is what we call. You can type your answer. Any material that possesses physical properties is called a... Your answer is very good. Substance. Let me say substance pala. Ito yung mga bagay that possesses any physical properties. Substance. Any substance, meron siyang mga physical properties. Next. Is distinguishing property of an object. When you say distinguishing property of an object, pagtukoy, pagkilanlan, kakilanlan, pagka... Okay, type your answer. If your answer is like an idiom, carry try. Now, let's proceed to the third one. Means to prove of something. Meron kang gustong patunayan. Meron kang ganito. Two letters na lang ang kulang, and that is very good. The correct answer is evidence. Now, last. Nag-alisa ito, medyo naging patunayan na naman ang kulang. Supposed to take on an opposite point. You are pertaining to the opposite point of a situation or something. Start with the letter R. Sige nga. RVRS. Oh, okay. The correct answer is you got it right. It's reverse. So these are the terms that to remember for us to really understand our lesson for this day. Those are substance, identity, evidence, and reason. To begin with, let us first define what is physical changes. All you need to do is to complete the following sentences for us to define what is physical changes. A change that occurs, can you choose on the circle, which is the appropriate word. A change that occurs, blank, changing the blank of the substance. Okay? So when we say physical changes, ano sa tingin niyo dyan? Alright. Change that occurs without changing the identity of a substance. And it has no new substance are being formed. Basically, when we say physical changes, there is a physical change pero without changing the identity of a substance. Like for example, if we cut paper, if we crumpled paper, it is still the paper. If we cut paper, paper pa din siya. The properties are still the same. There is no new substance are being formed. Another example, if we have a bottle drink, if we make that in a, if we cut that, it will still a bottle. Okay, another example, yan, a water molecules always have a same structure. So we are talking about the molecular structure or the molecules inside the water or inside the ice is still the same. If it is undergoing a different process like phase change, this picture shows that the water molecule do not change the components even when in different phases. Right? Yung kanyang component at H2O pa rin whenever undergo kahit nagbago pa, it is that there is a change to molecules. So when we say physical changes, it occurs without changing the identity of an object. It has no new substance. Ganun pa rin siya, and there's no change to molecules. So, again, a change that occurs, physical changes that occurs without changing the identity of the substance, and has no new substance at being formed. And yan. So, sir, what are the examples of physical changes? These are change in size, and change in size, in shape, or color. Like, for example, if we remove the spring in the notebook that you have, nagbago man yung shape niya kasi nga na-extend siya, nabanat niya siya, but it's still the spring, is still the spring. Hindi nagbago. Nag-change lang yung shape niya, pero ganun pa rin. Same thing if we color the gate in your home, or the door, or the ceiling, or the wall. If we apply color or paint, if we paint the wall, it is still the same. Yun pa rin siya, nag-change lang ng color. Moving forward, pencil shavings. Pag tinasahan natin yung pencil, yung pinagtasahan, it's also a part, the component is still part of the pencil. For paper, pinunit, size is still the same. There may be a change in size, pero paper pa rin yun. Nagbago man ang shape, din yun. Crush ice. May familiar yun. Plus, kahit kurin, lalo na ngayon, pag gumagawa ng halo-halo, ingredient siya, di ba? Part siya nun. Still ice pa rin siya, hindi naman nagbago. Or you can, sugar dissolved in water. Sugar in the water will be same as sugar. Paano nyo nalaman? Kasi matitigman natin na matamis na yung nasa water. Like from that painting, like what I discussed a while ago. But it's an example. Now, let's proceed. Define the chemical changes. So, when we say chemical changes, as complete sentence, I'm putting the word as a choices. Okay, a change that occurs that blank, the blank of a substance to change. Something blank is formed. No new substance with blank are formed. Okay, what do you think the first word to apply or to put in the first line? Alright, if you think chemical change is a change that causes the identity of the substance change. There is something, isa na lang yun sir. There is something new is being formed. New substance with new properties are formed. This is another changes. We call it chemical changes. Kabalik taran siya ng physical changes. Dito naman po, there is a causes and the identity of the substance being changed. Kung kanina, same identity, ngayon iba na ang identity, nagbago na. Something new is being formed. Kung kanina ganito siya, ngayon nagbago na, nagkaroon na ng ibang property. Ay bagong forma din. New substance with new properties are being formed. Kalugan, changing molecules. Sa physical change, there is no change. The molecules, the components of the substance ay the same. Ito man nagbago na. Take a look at iron. The atoms of iron, a chemical change has pipes rust. As you're familiar with pipe, yung bakal, yung makikita ninyong tubo na gawa sa bakal, no? This picture shows when an iron reacts with oxygen. There is a reaction with oxygen. Meron silang nag-react yung oxygen dun sa iron. That's why the molecular components are changed. Nagbago. As you notice niya, no? Di ba kanina iron lang siya? But because of the presence of oxygen na nag-react dun nga sa ating sa iron, there is a change in color as well as the change in that pipe rust. That's when there is a rust. Meaning to say, nag-react yung oxygen doon sa iron. That is what we call chemical changes. For you to fully understand these chemical changes, these are the evidence o evidensya na masasabi natin if a chemical changes happen. Look at the following pictures. Okay, first picture, there is a new color appears. Second picture, as you notice, there is a formation, a forming of heat, light, or sound, or given off, or either given up or absorbed. There is a bubble of gas or form, and yung odor may be noticed. Ikakaibang kami na. A solid material called a precipitate to form a liquid. Nagkaroon ng precipitation from solid naging to form a liquid. And last, the change is difficult or impossible to reverse. So, ngayon, let us answer this. Fill in the blank. New blank appears. Okay, first picture, no? We can see that there is a new color appears. If you combine something doon sa isang chemical, sa another substance, there is a change in color. That is what we call chemical change. Katulad nung sa example natin kanina. Doon sa iron, which is the metal, or the, what we call, pipe, there is, if you added oxygen, it will change the color. It will become rusty. Rust change of, aside from color, there is a change of odor. Yan, sabi rin. And bubbles are being produced. Precipitate forms in what kind of materials? Solid materials. Okay? Next. It is heat produced and light also produced. You can consider there is a chemical change. And next, sabi dito, sound is given off. Naririnig tayo na there is a sound. Okay, change is difficult kasi mag-reverse. Then we say reverse kanina, di ba? Mabalik into the original formation. Mabalik to the original position. Mabalik sa original niyang substance. Change is very difficult or impossible to reverse. Like for example, di ba, pag when we burn paper, when you burn paper, something, o di ba, pwede pa bang mabalik yung nasunog na into the original formation of the substance of the appearance of an object? Di ba, hindi na? Like for example, that is a example of chemical change and reaction with acid is an example. Like vinegar plus baking soda, it will release of carbon dioxide gases. If you combine that together, magkakaroon na carbon dioxide gases. Maririnig niyo siya na meron magpapak. That is a reaction with acid. Aside from that, reaction with oxygen naman, which is what we call oxidation. When iron, yeah, like the nail, no? If it is exposed with an oxygen, it will have a rust. That's why, kung makikita natin yung mga gate, di ba yung gate, it is made up of metal, hindi pala nagkakaroon, sir, lang because of the water. Always think that water is composition of hydrogen and oxygen. Kaya pala, pag nababasa yung water, kaya pag mas nahanginan, the presence of oxygen ay pertaining to the oxygen, it will form rust. There is a reaction with oxygen. The reaction with electricity, it will produce silver plate. Paliwanag. Okay? And next is the reaction between substances. Sodium plus chloride. You cannot identify which is the salt, sodium and chloride because naging nagkaroon ng formation ng salt. So, sodium chloride is the new the substance and it will become new forming a new substance which is the salt. Aside from that, the silver. Diba? The silver and the sulfur in the air naman nagbabuo ng tarnish na tinatawag. These are the application of our lessons na nagbabuo using the chemical changes. So, for you to fully understand, these are the other example of chemical change. Burning, wood burning, right? Metal rusting, food digesting. So, sobrang example of chemical change. Whenever you eat apple, whenever you eat a cut of a chicken, it will digest with the help of our digestive system and different organs that are responsible in digesting our food. Diba pagkalabas nun, hindi naman niya katulad, nagkaroon ng chemical reaction kasi may mga chemical sa ating mga katawan that are responsible to digest. Paglabas niya, yung mansanas pa rin ba? Same color po ba? Diba hindi na? It's a poop na. That's why there is a chemical change. Gasoline burning, diba? Is gasoline. As you can see, it will transfer na to different forms. And cake-making. Diba cake-making? But identify na pag hinalo-halo mo yung mga different ingredients sa cake. Kasi halo-halo na siya. And can you give another example sa science video? Sige nga. I will give you time to comment. Can you share your thoughts? Can you give an example ng mga chemical change na naiisip niyo aside sa nakalagay dito? Sige, comment your answer. I'm still waiting. Alright. Ano pa kaya naiisip yung chemical change aside from this? Alright. Sige. At this time, let us test your new knowledge. If you really understand the different chemical changes or the physical changes. Physical changes versus the chemical changes. The direction of the activity, all you need to do is to choose whether physical or chemical changes occurred in the following situation. We'll just choose this physical or chemical by commenting your answer in our chat box. Are we clear on that? Let's go. Let's have an example first. Water evaporates from ocean. Physical or chemical change? Sige nga. Physical change, a chemical change. Okay. 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. The correct answer is physical change. Let's get as an example, not specific number 1. A lag is split into 2 by an axe. It is physical change or chemical change? Nagbago ba ang kanyang appearance? Nakaform ba tayo ng new substance? In 3, 2, 1, the correct answer is physical change. Congratulations. Sa mga nakatulit, pencil is sharp. The pencil sharpener, leaving behind shaving. Okay, can you consider this a physical change sa pencil? A chemical change in 3, 2, 1. Of course, there is no substance being formed. That's why the answer is physical change. Now, let us proceed to number 3. The ice, the lake melts to become water in the lake. The ice on a lake melts, matunaw daw, become a water in the lake. So the components of an ice and water are still the same. That's why the correct answer is physical change. There is no new substance formed. How about this one? The charcoal in a pan turns to ash after several hours. So ano nangyari? After several hours, yung charcoal, it will turn to ash now. So there is a new substance formed. That's why the correct answer is very good. Yung answer is chemical change. Now, number 5, the yolk on it. Sulfur as a tarnish form of silver. Oh, look at the correct answer is chemical change because there is a new substance being formed. Oh, that's why another, always remember that the egg has contains a sulfur. A battery makes number 6. Oh, a battery makes electricity to turn on a flashlight. The correct answer is, of course, we have chemical change. Diba yung electricity nga? It will form to another substance. Hindi naman mababalik yung battery to its original compound. How about this one? Number 7. A bicycle rusts when left in the rain. Pag naiwan, since na hindi siya alloy, no? Metal siya. Gawa siya sa iron. Hindi siya alloy. Anong mangyayari? Nagkakaroon ng kalawang. What kind of change is that? Let us apply what we have learned. Very good. 3, 2, and 1. The correct answer is chemical change. Very good. Next. A shirt is accidentally torn. Anong sabi ng in a washing machine? Naipit, napunit, na-crumpled, torn. It is a physical or chemical change? Punit. Nagbago ba? Nagbago yung ba? The correct answer is physical change. Very good. Now let us conceptualize what we have learned, what you have learned in this lesson. Let us complete again this sentence for us to have a concept. You need to do is to put the right word or right term on the lines. Blank occurs when a substance, its appearance, blank, changing its, what will be the second word, and third and fourth to complete the concept. Okay. Of course, physical change occurs when a substance changes its appearance without changing its composition or substance. Diba? Physical change occurs when a substance changes its appearance without changing the composition. Nagbago lang yung itsura, pero ganun pa rin ang composition. Another chemical change naman siguro to. May clue na kayo. Ang first word is chemical change occurs when a substance is blank, it another substance with a blank composition and K. Chemical change occurs when a substance is transformed, very good, into another substance with a total different ba o properties. Totally different components, composition rather, and properties. And pakibasa nga. Isip, chemical change occurs when a substance is transformed, nagbago into another substance with a totally different composition and properties. Alright, time. So today, for the last time, let us be reminded the evidences of chemical. If you have the change of color, range of color, parang parehas to, color and odor. But odor, color, range of energy, of course, range of position, nagtago ba? Change it is difficult or impossible to reveal diverse. Okay? It's a formation of a precipitate. And we say, one of the evidence is a chemical change is the formation of gases, composition of organic matter, and light and or heat. So I hope that you really understand our lesson for today. And congratulations. Always remember that be the change or changes you. Hindi na niyo. Kayo ang magbago. Bago kayo baguhin ng pagbabago. Right now, we are facing a pandemic, no, class? Ito ay tinutuluan tayo magbago. Kailangan natin mag-isip kung ano ba dapat baguhin natin dahil sa pagbabago ng new normal, no? Pero let's be the change. Let's think ng mga bagay na kailangan ng pagbabago sa ating sarili at sa ating community kung nasa naman tayo. Do not forget to trust God and in facing changes sa buhay natin. Changes is inevitable at laging nangyayari. That is our life lesson. Do you have any more questions, clarifications? If wala na, abay na tayo kay Dexter. Pero bago tayo magpaalam, may go to Science Google Classroom. Think, link for quiz and worksheet. God bless. Wala mo nang aalis. At mag-stay muna dyan. Mag-left lang pagtapos na. Alright.
Are you ready? In 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1.